Welcome to the first Brain Gym, which is going to be a continuing series of questions to help you complete your learning process or learning cycle. When I teach it, you might feel it's really simple and you're able to understand it. But you are able to only verify whether your understanding is complete and correct once you actually begin to do things on your own. This is especially important for programming logic because it's a skill like learning a cycle. You need to learn it once in your life and you will never forget it ever. All right. So what I am doing is in this first session, I am giving you a few simple exercises to help you reinforce your learning about sequential logic. By the word sequential logic, I mean problems like area of a circle, okay, area of a rectangle, sum of two numbers, exchange two numbers. So based on what I have done to you or what I have done in the previous videos, this is going to help you check whether you have really understood by trying to solve new problems. Now, this particular document as a PDF will be loaded in the description section of this particular video. You are required to download this document, look at the questions, and try to answer or make a sincere effort to answer these questions. You may maintain a notebook where you write down this question and write down the answer so that you have a record later on. Now, at some point later, maybe in a week, I'll discuss the solutions to this given problem. So then you'll be able to verify whether what you have done is right or wrong. The very first thing I would like to tell you is, for each of the problems, you must draw a test table, something similar to this one for finding the sum of two numbers. And at each step, see what all the values of the variables change. And automatically at any step, if you're not getting the desired or expected result, that means your logic is wrong. So for each and every question, I expect you to draw the test table and write the answers to the questions asked. Now you're no longer school kids. So I see still somewhat of a school kind of a behavior where a lot of you get excited to put the solution in the comments, or you like to say, sir, 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 madam, madam. That's okay at the school level. Now you need to be a lot more mature, develop that ability to check the correctness of the solution on your own. Why? Because in 2 to 3 years or 4 years, you'll be working on the job. Who is going to check the problem or the solution you have done? It is your job and you have to learn it right from now. And it is our job to train you to be able to correct yourself or learn yourself or evaluate yourself. So for all of the programming we do, the entire programming courses I do, you will never ever require anyone to check your answers, or you should not be using anyone to check your answers. Otherwise, I will assume that you have not learned this correctly or you have not understood it. You can 100% verify the solution using the test table, because suppose if I had made some mistake, I would not have got the correct output. That's how I understand that something is wrong. Then go back at different steps and see where you went wrong. That's a skill you need to develop. Then, most importantly, please do not write solutions to any of these problems in the comments. You're just wasting your time, because I'm not going to display them at all. Because what happens is, people learn at different speeds. Somebody who is slow doesn't mean he's dull or useless. It is just that they have a different mindset. So just give everybody a time, let them learn. Don't get tempted to search for the solution on the web. In fact, for a lot of them, you may not find a solution on the web, so don't worry about it. So make an effort, do not write the solution in the comments. Grow up now, all right? Show a little maturity, evaluate yourself. If you have a friend nearby, go and sit with him and get him together. You can check your logic. Now, write down the answer in a notebook and wait for the solution of this to be provided in this particular video description itself. I'll try to provide, or I shall make a video, discuss the solutions to these problems and provide a link for doing a self-checking and cross-verification. Since this is the first time I'm giving you the solution, in future I may just give you the answers and you should be able to easily cross-verify. So this construction of a test table where every step of the algorithm and all the variables involved or all the variables which are responsible for getting the result should be listed and their value should be changed and seen what is the outcome of that algorithm. Next thing. Now what I am doing is the first problem is about sequential logic problem is again I am reminding you the algorithm logic must be verified using a test table like this. And what I will do is most of the time I will give you sample input and output values and you should using the sample input and output just see if you are getting the correct result. For example, in the first algorithm I have given you the length of a rectangle. I am asking you to calculate the length of a rectangle assuming you are given the area and breadth. You should make an assumption that area is never going to be zero, because if area is zero you are going to have different problems. I don't want to deal with it right now. So you will have to write the algorithm, do a testing like this and see whether you are getting the correct length using these values. Next algorithm, write algorithm to calculate the product and sum of two numbers represented in memory by two variables A and B. So for the same two variables, you are going to get the sum as well as you are going to get the product. So these are the values of A, B. You should list the values of sum. Just see what are the values of sum and product you are getting. Now the second one is, okay. What I have done here is I have written some code. Okay, Arjun has written an algorithm which prints the result of a division for a fixed numerator based on the value of the denominator provided by the user. The numerator is fixed as 100. The user is going to enter the denominator and you need to predict what will be the result for different test values. If you are smart, you should also be able to tell me what is going to be one major problem with this particular approach of doing this logic. All right. Now, what I have done is here I have written some algorithm which is definitely not correct. What I am trying to do in this algorithm logic is suppose I have x as 10, y as 20, z as 30. I want to move the value of x to y, y to z and z to x. That means I am trying to go into a circle. So x will be 30, y will be 10 and z will be 20. So for that I have written a logic. First, using this logic, create a test table and predict what will be the output of this particular algorithm for 3-4 different values. You can take x, y and z and you can take the values 2, 6, 9, minus 3, 0, 4, okay, 5, minus 9, 1. So you can take these different values of x, y, z and produce a test table and see what is the final value of x, y, z in this particular logic. Go step by step and see how the values of x, y and z change and tell me what is the output. Now, since I'm telling you there is some problem in this logic or algorithm, I would want you to rewrite this in a correct fashion. All right. Then lastly, just one problem. There is a piece of logic I have given. The logic is incorrect and there are certain portions of the logic missing. I want you to fix this logic as well as put in the missing portion. What this problem is telling you is there is a teaching assistant. Generally in the West, they have assistants to teachers who are juniors. So a teaching assistant is required to go to visit every classroom. Ask the teacher how many are present that day and knowing the total number of students in that particular class, he should be able to calculate how many are present and how many are absent. He should be able to actually find out how many students are absent. So look at this. This is a complete mess. Okay, I want you to correct this. Then also think of what all possible problems that this student may encounter. I'll give you ideas once you come back with it. So please make an effort to sit. Solve this. I cannot see it taking more than 30 minutes, assuming you have understood sequential logic 1, 2, 3 and what is an algorithm. Once you do it, for the nth time, please do not put your solution in the comments. Draw a test table and verify on your own. If you ask me at the end of logic, what is the most important skill I want you to learn? The most important skill is being able to tell whether the logic is correct or wrong. Because a lot of times when you go on job, you will be trying to correct somebody else's logic if there are problems. So you should be able to run through the test table and see whether the logic is right or not. Because this is a very important skill which will come with you for life, and you're going to be a terrific programmer by following the tips I am giving you. With this, let me wish you a goodbye.